Greetings, friends. Today, I would like to share with you a very interesting concept which might be very useful to you when you deal with conflict. Conflict is quite common, especially when there is differences in points of view. And when there is differences in point of view, two or few people who are involved in it needs to come into an interaction. Now, based on each person's interaction personality, the quality of interaction can vary. So I would like to introduce the interaction personality model and the concept so that you can start reflecting on the quality of interactions you have. If it's healthy, why is it healthy? If it's not very healthy, why is it not healthy? How can you work towards having high quality interactions with people around you, be it your family, your team members, your customers, your society, it doesn't matter. So as you see in the screen, we have this matrix built on where the x-axis talk about the mutuality. So mutuality means if you are low mutuality, you don't care about the needs of other people. And if you have high mutuality, you actually care about other people's needs. So that's your x-axis. And then you've got the y-axis, where it is about assertiveness. So high assertiveness means you care about your own needs. And low assertiveness means you don't care about your own needs too. Now, based on the matrix, you can find five different personalities. So the first personality I would like to talk about is quite a common one, is a situation where you're high in assertiveness and low in mutuality. That means you care about your needs, but you don't care about other people's needs. And this is a personality called the challenger. The challenger personality always wants to prove that they are right. It's like my way or the highway. I make the decisions, I call the shots. I don't allow you to speak because I am always right. And that's the challenger personality. They want to win at any cost. And they have a mindset which is called win-lose. I want to win and it's okay for you to lose. And that's the challenger personality. Now, if you look at the other extreme of challenger, which is mutuality is high, where you actually care about other people's needs, but assertiveness is low, where actually you don't care about your needs. And these people are called the martyrs. So the martyrs are people who like to sacrifice. You like to give in. You like to let go of your position. You want to keep the other person happy. We want peace in the team. You want togetherness in the team. So you'll allow yourself to take a back seat and even get beaten up, but ensure that the other person is happy in what they do and just go with their viewpoints and decisions and solutions and suggestions, which is the martyr situation. The martyr personality is a situation where it's a lose-win situation. I lose, you win, and that's okay. Now, the third personality is where you're high on mutuality as well as high on assertiveness, where you care about your needs as well as you care about the other person's needs. And these are problem solvers. They always try to listen to the other's point of view, understand what their needs are, what their concerns are, explain your needs and your concerns, talk together, go into a problem-solving mode and come up with a solution where both people are happy. And that's called a win-win mindset. You win and I win. And that's great for the two of us. That's the third mindset. Now, if you take the other extreme of the problem-solver, it's a situation where I'm low on both. I'm low on mutuality, low on assertiveness. I don't care about my needs, neither about your needs. And these people are called the evaders. So evaders are people who would like to avoid the issue, postpone it, talk about something else, Let it be, hoping that it'll solve itself. Give it time. And that's the evader. The evader, as you would have guessed by now, is a lose-lose situation. Now, right in the middle of all four, as you see in the graph, you have a personality which is called the deal maker. Now, deal maker is someone who would go 50-50. If you offer me something for 20,000 and I want to buy it at 10,000, the deal maker will say, okay, let's go half here, let's make it at 15,000. So it's like, you know, you give in something, I'll give in something, we'll meet halfway. You don't know at the end of it what kind of value a deal maker gets. It could be any of the four values. So the deal maker can end up as a lose-lose, can end up as a win-win, win-lose or lose-win, any of the four, based on the approach you take. Now, out of these four, what do you think is the best mode for you? Some of you might think, I think problem solver looks a good one. But problem solver is good because we are listening to all points of view. But the issue with problem solver is it's going to take a long time. And sometimes if you have a time limit, you may want to quickly get on with the decision. So in that situation, you may have to go to competing. The issue with competing is it's quick. You can stand up for what you want and get things done. But being a challenger means that others would not be listened to. You might miss good points of view. So being a challenger is also not very helpful. Now you might think martyr is a nice person. Yes, martyr is nice. But if you are always a martyr, what happens is that your ideas will never be considered. Everyone will keep walking over you because you're always giving in to the other person. So whilst martyr might bring peace to the team, martyr also has the negative or disadvantages that, you know, it might not be useful to get your ideas onto the team. Now, what are the pluses and minuses of the evader? Evader looks like it's difficult to find a plus for it, but the plus of an evader is if you're preoccupied with something more important and if you have the evader mindset, you could postpone it, you can put it off, you could, you know, focus on something else. And sometimes you need to be an evader as well. But the problem with evader is you keep postponing and you don't deal with issues, which happens. Now, the issue with deal maker is that, yes, you might come with a quick solution, but you don't know where you'll end up, whether you will get a win-win or a win-lose, lose-win or a lose-win or win-lose. So therefore, looking at the five modes, you will see that all these five modes have pluses and all have minuses as well. So therefore, for you to be successful, you should have the ability to do all five modes, but be able to decide which mode will suit which situation. It's situational. In some situations, you may have to be a challenger. Some situations you may have to be a martyr. Some situations you have to quickly get into problem solver. In some situations you have to be an evader and even be a deal maker in some situations. So if you have one of these modes which are high, for example, if you are naturally a challenger, you'll always challenge situations. And you keep challenging, and that even if you should not be challenging, you'll be still challenging. On the other hand, if you are a martyr, you will be a martyr all the time when you have to be actually a challenger. So your invitation is to identify what area you are in and reduce the strong area and improve on the areas that require improvement. How do you know what you are? What mode you belong to? And to do that, we have an assessment for you where you can go to sensei-assessments.com. Go online and take the interaction personality assessment and find out for yourself which of the five categories you belong to. And not only that, we will also let you know to what extent you belong to each of the category. And you'll get a report which talks about your interaction personality and how to make the best of it and how to improve yourself as well. And after looking at the report, if you still need more information, if you need a one-on-one coaching session, if you want to do the assessment for the rest of your team, or if you want to do some team building work based on the interaction assessment reports, we'll be very happy to engage with you, talk with you, and find the best solution for you so that you can use it to deliver strategic business results of your organization. Till we meet sometime, I wish you all the best. Thank you so much. Good luck.